Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to Junk Gaming Videos New York Mets franchise series here in MLB 15, the show on the PS4. Now the Mets are up 2-1 in the NLCS against the Pittsburgh Pirates, getting ready to start game four, and here we go. Jose Altuve puts this ball in play and fairly deep to center field. It's going to stay in the park, however, and be a long out number one. 3-2 count to Lagares, and he is going to strike out on the high heat there. He's got to go sit down. Two outs in the Mets' first inning. 2-1 count to Kadire, right on the money, but right at the shortstop. 1-2-3 inning. The Pirates go grab the bats in the bottom of the first, and this is the lineup they'll be putting forth today against Jonathan Nease. So here we go. This is a 3-1 count, and he loses the first batter. Not the way that Nease wants to start. Works 1-2 to the next man, Polanco. That's going to be put out to center field and will be caught. So now with one out and a 3-2 count to Andrew McCutchen, the pitch is low and he loses him as well. Two walks in this first inning and still only one out. See if he can get out of this. This pitch is put into play. Could be a double play ball. Steps on second. Throws to first for two. And the Mets get out of the... Well, I don't know if you call that a jam, but two runners on in the first. We go to the bottom of the second now. This ball hit to the gap in right center field, but it is tracked down by Kadire out there. One out. 3-2 count to Neil Walker, who's been striking out a lot in the series, but he'll take a walk right there. The third issued by Nease already. So 2-2 with one out. Corey Hart hits this ball deep. He's going to make him pay for this walk. It is gone. A two-run homer. And Pittsburgh jumps out to the early lead. Home run ball. Corey Hart, as you saw in the lineup screen, had not gotten a hit in the postseason, or at least in this series, whatever that was tracking. But he's erased that in a big way, pulling this pitch down the left field line and gone for a two-run shot. Now, with just one out, Nease has to get himself collected and get out of this inning. This is another fly ball to left, but should be playable and is. Two outs. 1-2 pitch here to the next batter. 38 pitches through two innings already. That's the pitcher right there taking strike three. But the inning's a successful one for the Pirates, putting two on the board. We go to the top of the third now, and the Mets trying to get those runs back. This is going to be a base hit to right field to start what might be a Mets rally. And now Jonathan Nease at the plate. He's going to be bunting. He puts it up in the air, but it's not going to be caught. Cervelli throws to first and does just get him out. So sacrifice is good, and we turn the lineup over. Here is Altuve. Oh, nice extension right there by the shortstop to get up and get that one, or it could have been in the gap. Two outs now in a 1-2 count. That is fair, bouncing over the bag. Fair ball, should score a run. Here he comes to the plate. The throw is to the plate. You see the runner kind of slow down on the last few steps. Actually made that a closer play than it should have been, but he is safe. The lead is now 2-1, Pittsburgh. Kadire hits this sharply to right field, but it is caught, and the inning is over. So the Mets cut into that lead and make it a 2-1 ball game. Pirates get nothing in the third. We go to the top of the fourth, and here is Granderson coming up with a base hit to right field. He's on and starting off the Mets in the fourth inning. 3-0 count to David Wright. This is a dangerous spot to be in. He's swinging, and that's a base hit to the right side. We got runners at first and second all of a sudden. Now the pitch to Tejada, and that's through into center field. Run coming to the plate, and the throw is offline. We've got a tie game at two. Mets are right back in it here, and John Mayberry Jr. at the plate. 1-2 count, nobody out in this inning, and he smacks his pitch to center field. Deep and gone, a three-run shot, the Mets. Have the 5-2 lead in one swing of the bat. John Mayberry Jr. goes deep off of Lock, and he wants that pitch back, doesn't he? Yes, sir. Drilled a long way to right center, and it's 5-2 Mets. Nobody out in this inning. That's going to be a little grounder to short and a nice play all in one motion throwing him out. We have a 3-2 count with Nease at the plate again. He's going to work a walk. You don't want to be walking the pitcher. No, 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 not at all. That's not a recipe for success. Altuve at the plate now with one out. He stings one to left field. That'll be down for a hit. First and second now with one out. Pirates can't be too happy with how this is turning out. They're going to go to their bullpen and get Rob Scahill in the game. He's got a 3-2 count, and he issues a walk to Lagares. You got the bases loaded now with one out and a chance for this to get really, really messy fast. Kadire up the middle, base hit. One run scores. Another one coming to the plate. The throw not in time. Altuve scores as well. It's a 7-2 ball game. Granderson up now. Still only one out. Going to chop that back to the pitcher. They could get two. There's one. Granderson too fast. They can't double him up. Inning continues. 3-0 count to David Wright. Oh, that was really close. Very borderline, but they call that ball four. And the bases are once again loaded. This is not a spot you want to be in. 1-2 count. Tejada lifts that one to right field. They're going to get out of it with anything further scoring, but already a disastrous inning if you're the Pirates. They're down 7-2 now. Nice working in the bottom of the fourth. That's going to be a grounder. It's going to be fielded. The throw to first in the stretch. They get him. 3-2 count with one out. And this is Mercer off the mound and into center field for a base hit. Pirates looking to get some runs of their own here to pull back closer to the Mets. And this is going to be Neil Walker with solid contact. And it's going to get in the gap. He's been having a rough series at the plate, but maybe not anymore. That run is going to come around third and try to score. He is in there. It's now a 7-3 ball game. The catcher misses that. What is he doing? Luckily, Nice is backing up the play. Catcher looked like he wanted no part of that. Spatter check swing, but it ends up down the line fair. Just dunked it out to left field. Put that bat head out there. Gets a hit. Lucky, but they'll take it. 7-4 now. Two outs and that's going to be it short, and the play is made. So the inning is over, but the Pirates get two back and make it 7-4. Already a crazy game. We go to the fifth. Mayberry Jr. has already hit one out of here. This one's deep. Could it be number two? No, it's high off the wall, just missing his second home run. He will get into second with a double, however. And the Mets continue to pound Pittsburgh pitching. This is A.J. Burnett on the mound now, I believe, and he issues a walk. Oh, this is not getting any better. They're setting themselves in a bad spot here. How about a bunt from Jonathan Nice? Gets it down. Nice play. Covering first. The throw is offline. He's safe. Everyone's safe. Base is loaded. Nobody out. They couldn't even take the sacrifice and get that taken care of. And now it's a walk to Altuve with the bases loaded. We'll force home Mayberry Jr. And another run is home. Burnett struggling right here. It's 8-4. Still nobody out. This pitch to Lagares. Fair. And it's down for a hit. They're going to hold everyone. One run scores. Bases are loaded. It's 9-4. Michael Kadire. What's he going to do on the 1-1 pitch from Burnett? He's going to hit it hard over the shortstop's head and into the gap. It's cut off by the center fielder, but it's not going to stop two runs from scoring. It's 11-4. The Mets are pounding and pounding. Pirates pitching here. They got to go to the bullpen again. That's luckily for the Pirates. Fielded at shortstop, and they get the first out of the inning. 3-2 count to David Wright. He's going to hit this to right field. It's going to be caught. Runner is going to stay put right there. He's not going to try to tag to third. Two outs now. 1-2 count. Can they finally get out of this inning? Tejada. Oh, what a play by Neil Walker right there. Gets up and is able to make the catch to end the inning. Pirates are in deep trouble, though, already down 2-1, and this could be very bad news if they go down 3-1 in their own ballpark. But whoa, we got some interesting outfield play by Kadire there. Can't make the play. He's going for the inside the park home run. Or was it an error? I don't know how they're going to call it. Either way, Polanco scores, and it's 11-5. I'm not sure how they went with that one. There's an error on the board for the Mets. Kadire had trouble out in the outfield there, but he hasn't had trouble with the bat. He's had two hits already, and here's a gapper to left center. All right, his third hit of the game, and it's going to be an extra base hit. He's got a double. Oh, wait, but he's not done there. Going for third. He's going to be out. No, they say safe. What? Did he miss the tag? How is he safe at third? That's just the way the game's going for the Pirates right now. 3-2 count, and that pitch misses to Granderson. There have been a lot of walks in this game on both sides. Runners at the corners now for David Wright, and he hits this one to center field. It is going to be a catch. Oh, what a great catch. The run is going to tag up and score, but McCutchen goes all out to make that catch. 3-2 with two outs now, and Tejada puts that in play. It should end the inning with a throw to first base. Plenty of damage being done on the scoreboard by the Mets, though. 12-5 after 7. After 8 innings, things have finally settled down as far as runs going on the board. We go to the 9th inning. Could they be getting more here? Well, there's a base hit to right, and they've got a runner on with nobody out. 0-2 count, and Michael Kadire is going to strike out on the fastball. That's some high heat for you right there. So one out. Granderson's got 2 strikes on him. He's going to put the ball in play. Looks like a double play ball. 1-2. Had to stretch. It was a high throw. But they do get Granderson to complete the double play. So time to shut this down and take the 3-1 lead. Oh, yeah. You know the Mets are having thoughts of the World Series now. If they can get within 1 game of getting there. But hold up. There's a base hit to right. We've seen some big innings in this game. So hold all bets. You never know what could happen. This is going to hit the left, and that's going to be out number 1. Okay, 2 more. Let's get these nailed down. McCutchen at the plate. He chases. Strike 3 swinging. 2 outs now. Mets need just 1 more, and it will be put in play here. Can this be tracked down in center field? It will, and the game is over. The Mets win and take the 3-1 series lead. Going into Game 5, your player of the game, John Mayberry Jr., he definitely swung a big bat today, hit the home run with 3 RBIs, had a double as well. So 12-5 is your final. The Mets take a stranglehold in the series. Will they finish it off next game? You'll have to come back and find out. Leave a like, and we'll see you next time for more Mets baseball.